Reception here in Preston's Guild Hall for the ever-popular Alex Higgins as he started tonight 7-0 down against Steve Davis in the Coral United Kingdom Professional Championship. And then Higgins gave his fans what they'd waited for. The black ball that gave him his first frame, the first success of the day. But everyone knew that he was still going to need every lucky charm he could get. Black cats and all, but the score was Steve Davis 7, Alex Higgins 1 in his best of 31 frame final over the 2 days. Higgins this afternoon had missed his chances. Davis had looked unstoppable. So here's frame 9, 7 to play here this evening. Our commentators Rex Williams and Jack Carnham, 11-21. Davis playing.
One. Seven.
That was a long way out for Steve, and I would think Alex is breathing a sigh of relief there.
Seven.
Hasn't drifted quite far enough on the blue. He's either got to settle for a long one or punch it down the table and back. Wow, good heavens, that ball jumped 3 foot in the air.
Alex Higgins, seven.
Well, that must be the highest I've seen, Rex.
Yes, certainly didn't run off, did it?
Thank you.
Well, if Steve can get the angle on the side cushion, he'll probably try and lie on the red, which is by the black. Not sure if he's got the angle to get by the yellow ball. Well, from that picture, it looks as though it's very doubtful. Certainly, if he can, that's the shot that he would like to play. And he'll have to be absolutely dead weight to hide the other red. Otherwise, Alex could be able to cut a red in. He's looking at another red now, but certainly a fair bit of danger. He's looking at coming twice across the table. Was the red that he was afraid of leaving, and I think Alex can cut it in. Well, he's a little bit short of pace. And a rather anxious look from Alex to see if Steve can get through to the red, but as you can see from the picture, he can't. He's got to get this one absolutely spot on to hide that red.
Very accurate shot indeed.
Five.
this blue he's looking at certainly isn't easy, and of course there are two very open reds there.
Yes, that was a good shot, Jack, and he couldn't do anything with it, just roll it in, but I think he can get this red to the corner. Tonight Alex getting what running is going.
We did say that if Alex could match Steve Davis for safety, we might see perhaps a change in the running, and possibly we are. Well, Alex here getting up on the table for a complete masse stroke around the black. And slid off the ball.
He'll be quite happy with that. Didn't get the desired effect on the ball, but he's got it safe. Well, it's another one that we don't normally expect Steve Davis to miss.
Six. Seven. Ten.
Didn't quite have the angle
14.
That he wanted to come off the cushion. Tried to stun it a little bit to widen the angle.
Steve Davis, 14.
Well, I know the feeling. He feels that he wants a ladder. And this will be a good one. Bad luck.
Four.
Nod of the head by Steve there, the essay season not being too successful. And I think he's left this one.
I'm not sure if it will go by the pink. Jackie can certainly get to the red all right, but it's pretty tight. Well, he's got out of it pretty well.
From the audience there. I think they're willing, Alex, to try and pull another one back. This is by far the longest frame so far, some 35 and a half minutes, and it possibly does seem that he may have taken the edge off of Steve's putting.
Hasn't come out quite as far as he would have liked to have done. This is still missable, this shot.
Eight.
And Alex needs the colours up to the blue, and including the blue, to make the game safe.
This certainly looks like the frame to Alex, and both players in the middle section of the frame have had an opportunity to take it.
20.
So, seven frames to two, favour of Steve Davis.
And now has the first night of this two-day final produced a new Higgins, twice a finalist, never a champion, against the man who's won it twice. Certainly a Higgins charge could change the match completely. We'll be back here at 11:35. At the moment, the self-styled people's champion seems to have found an opening. First day here at the Carl 1983 Professional Snooker Championship Final, being played out between Steve Davis, who won here in 1980 and 81, and Alex Higgins in his third final. He's never won it yet. Well, this afternoon it was Davis all the way, 7-0. The Higgins fans despondent. And then this evening, well, they were looking for the revival. Higgins didn't disappoint at the beginning. It was 7-1, then 7-2. Remember, this is a best of 31 frame final being played out over the 2 days. So 7-2 to Davis. Let's join the very next frame. And it's Steve Davis trailing here. He hasn't scored yet. Higgins has 20 points on the board. Rex Williams and Jack Carnham commentating.
6. Steve Davis, 12.
Well, that was a long way away for Steve, and what wouldn't think it was the same player that we saw this afternoon. A lovely shot, and I think that he's got a lovely chance to leave a nice angle on the pink to open the bunch of reds, and there you see where he intends to leave the cue ball. That's his next shot, to pop the pink from that position.
Seven.
Well, that was one out of the book. It's a question of shall I or shan't I?
Alex,
discretion was a better part of valor there.
Yes, that had to be the best shot because those reds are just loosely together, and it's not easy to lie on them and leave it perfectly safe. Playing to come up the back of them, try and line the two reds nearest the pink. And he's misjudged that, I think. I think there's a red that will go into the centre pocket. The red into the right-hand centre pocket will go. Mm.
6.
No, that's a good one. Bad luck. 11. Wanted to pass the pink, take it back into the left-hand pocket.
Certainly a wonderful opportunity for
13.
Alex Higgins to pull another frame back.
Well,
just a simple roll through with the pink here, and I think he should be home and dry in this frame. Forty-two the lead. 59 on the table.
21. Well, this red will be enough to leave Steve needing a snooker again.
Played with a lot of side on that too. Hold the pace of the 41. Cue ball off the cushion. And considering the, shall we say, ordeal that Alex has been through today, he's beginning to stroke the ball very nicely indeed. 42. And come back and take the first three frames of the evening 49. Session after having a real thumping of 7-0 is a very good performance.
51.
So Alex making his first break over 50 in the final so far.
63. 69.
And greedy for the black as well. That's good to see. So as he pots the black, he takes the frame score to 7-3.
What a change in it all now. Higgins looking as alive tonight as he looked dead this afternoon, but still 4 frames down. Here in the next, the breaks have been coming. Davis 7 of 35, Higgins of 32 to bring us to this score with Davis to play.
looking to skim past the red to go back down the table. Gotta be careful. Well, that's certainly a skinny one. And a dead snooker as well.
Alex in real trouble this time. Looking at coming off the side cushion, dropping behind the red, which is nearest to the cushion. But he's got to get the direction and weight spot on. No room for error on this shot.
Well, magnificent. Played that with a lot of left-hand side to clip it off the cushion. But missed by a whisker. And Steve says, have another go.
Davis 39, Alex Higgins 37.
Middle of the frame, this is quite very tense and very well played bout of safety, and this time Steve is in trouble.
Yes, before the session started, Jack, Alex was saying that he was unable to close the game down this afternoon. The ball split open so beautifully each time and he couldn't keep Steve out, but it was his plan to try and close the game down, and he's certainly done that this evening, and it's paid dividends.
Ball stroke, four, Alex Higgins.
Alex would have preferred him to have hit the red. He would have certainly had a reasonably easy shot afterwards and a chance to win the game, but nothing easy from this position. I think he'll settle for that one. this time, if Steve does miss the reds, it's not as easy to keep it safe, because the cue ball almost certainly stop at the other end of the table.
Ball stroke, four, and a free ball, Alex Higgins.
Well, I think the there is a red into the centre, but not easy, and committing himself rather.
Colour that he can get on the final red from is the blue, and that would be very risky. Pink is the easiest colour to play, but he can't get on the red from that. And I think that's a very sensible choice of shot.
Well, actually, that was bad luck for a very difficult shot by Alex, because the angle that he went onto and came off the cushion was not natural at all. And with a lot of bottom and power on the cue ball, he actually squared the angle off the cushion and almost made it. And this is almost becoming a desperate frame for both players, because Alex can take four consecutive, and equally mentally for Steve, that would be quite a blow. So it's very important to both players at this particular stage of the match.
Certainly a desperate struggle this game, and a change of fortunes for both players. They've had each other in a lot of trouble.
Thank you.
Well, that was a very nice shot. Wasn't an easy shot to play on the tap on the table from Steve to say that he acknowledged that it was a good shot.
Well, that's an amazing shot when you see the antics that Alex gets up to with his body. It's quite a mystery how he knocks them in.
Yes, he's very unlucky there, not to be able to get a collar. He can put Steve in trouble, but he could have won the game from that position. No problem in hitting the yellow here. He'll put a fair bit of pace into the ball.
Well, and there we see that little bit of luck that comes into the game, and to get it at a vital stage like that must hurt Alex a little. So 46 points each after a battle of some 31 minutes. Well, that really is unkind. What a pity that these things happen, have to happen in these very vital games. So the blue really settles it. So the pink, just to make sure. And Steve Davis, I think, is going to be a little fortunate to have won this frame in this fashion to take an 8-3 lead. And that is at the end of this first evening session.
Leaving them four more to play, and we'll be seeing play from every one of them here in our programme tonight. Well, Higgins was being forced into errors there. That's what's happened to Davis in this next frame, and he's trailing. 4:30. John Spencer and Ted Lewis moved into the commentary box.
Six.
7. Fourteen. 17.18. 24.
And now when he pots this left-hand red here, he'll open the path for the other two into the opposite corner pocket.
25.
Just give this young man half a chance. Now goes 4 points in front.
31.
Well, that blue got away, John.
Yes, he hit it much too thick, and of course this is why he's left the white, the position on the red, short, but Alex can cut this in.
Alex Higgins, 4. Steve Davis, 35. Alex Higgins, 34. One.
I come to vote for better than that. Just has to roll the blue in now to finish nicely on the yellow.
Six. 5 points in front then, and just the colours to go.
Eight. 11.
Just looking at the board to see that he needs brown and blue to clinch this frame.
15. 20. Ball stroke, 4, Steve Davis.
I think he's having a go at this one.
Higgins, one. Foul stroke for Alex Higgins. One.
And he snooked himself.
Yellow ball.
Using a terrific amount of right-hand side there, Alex was able to curve the cue ball around the reds onto the yellow. Got the cue ball very safe once again. Chance then for Steve Davis. Both these stars have fought their way to this particular final twice before. Steve here having won it twice. Title in 1918-81, missed out last year. Alex, in fact, has lost out twice.
Lots of noise playing this to try and finish on the pink of the black.
Six.
It'll make a bit of difference, John, if he gets that black on its spot.
Yes, this is. It just needs to get good position on one of these reds now, and they spread wide enough. Just nudge that red just to the right of the black out of the way of the other one.
Oh dear. 14.
Quiet face.
Now, those are the type of shots that really upset these professional stars.
Yes, probably tended to just look at the red he was going to move and took his eye off the blank.
One. Nine. 16. Seventeen. 22.
And Alex certainly won't have any better chances of winning a frame than this one.
30.
The reds and the colours set nicely in the centre of the table.
That
was a very good shot there. Now put all three reds in nice possible positions.
46.
And just the red. A red and one
52.
More colour to leave Steve needing snookers.
53. 59.
His mind ticking over, and Steve there must be feeling that these points should be his.
60. 66.
Points in front as he comes to the cars.
70. 71.
While Steve Davis took his eye off the black ball, Alex capitalized and is now within three frames. Steve Davis leading 8 frames to 5. Alex Higgins getting his tail up.
Six.
That's an excellent shot. Playing position in towards the reds, so he'd have choice of the three. I think what Alex is looking at here, he can get on the black very easily, but there's a red just to the left of the black spot there, so he won't want to tie the black up.
Seven.
At the rate Lincoln is keen this cue ball, you'll want a new pair of gloves. Just a few moments ago, Alex would have never have attempted that particular shot.
Seventeen.
I think the black will go into this left-hand corner pocket.
Twenty-five. Thirty-three.
And these the first points of this 13th frame.
34. Forty-one. 42.
Unlucky.
49. Some
brilliant play coming from the tip of the cue of Alex Higgins. Absolutely perfect.
Good pot there from Alex, could clinch this frame, 50 points in front now, and enough reds wide out in the middle of the table to win this frame.
Six. 13.
That puts him 67 in front with 67 left on the table.
18.
And what a battler this 34-year-old Irishman is.
23.
Lost all seven frames on the first session of this 31-frame final, and now fighting back, he's won six of the seven frames this evening.
Steve Davis then stays in his chair, concedes the frame, and there's just two frames in it. Alex trailing six frames to eight.
So tonight, all the flair, all the flow, helped by the odd drop of lager, coming from Alex Higgins, a complete transformation of what we're seeing here this afternoon. One more to play tonight. Higgins already has points on the board. 32 to him, nothing to Steve Davis.
One. Nine. Fifteen.
Oh dear.
One.
The cue ball once again to the laundry.
Vital red, we can stun this through for the black. An excellent chance of clinching this game.
Seven. Fourteen. 15.
What a performance 22. This is.
Deep screw coming down for the two reds on the black cushion. So that puts him 40 in front with 43 on the table, just one red left required to leave Steve needing snookers again.
Alex has a habit of tapping his cue on the side of the table there. For those of you who wonder what it is, in fact, he's getting rid of the surplus chalk on the tip.
Higgins, 30.
And there Alex just electing to knock the yellow into a safe position in case Steve should get the snookers required.
The two stars there. A fascinating first day's play of the 31-frame final. Steve is 41 points behind and therefore requires two snookers. Terrific performance by this former world snooker champion to draw back from 7-0 down after the afternoon session.
Thank you.
two brilliant pots there, certainly drawing the curtains on the first day's play of this UK Championship final.
And Steve comes forward, shakes the hand of Alex Higgins, who draws back to within just one frame. Steve Davis leading 8-7.
What a final this has now become. A whitewash this afternoon for Steve Davis, almost a whitewash for Higgins tonight. And the Higgins army of fans who at one stage were wondering what they were going to do tomorrow night, with this evening queuing up to shake the hand of their hero once again. Remember, 16 frames needed to win the United Kingdom title. And tomorrow, the hero will be playing Steve Davis at 1:55 here. Please join us. And a very good afternoon as we start our ninth and final day here at Preston, covering the 1983 Carl United Kingdom Professional Snooker Championship. This afternoon and this evening, the last two sessions of the final. And a final yesterday which took a quite remarkable course. A final of complete contrast between Alex Higgins in his third final, he's never won the title, against Steve Davis, who's won here twice before in 1980 and 81. And now, as we start this afternoon, there's just one frame between them. Alex Higgins, 7, Steve Davis, 8. And the Guildhall here at Preston, which has seen some quite remarkable snooker over the period of the tournament, rapidly filling up. It is a complete sellout. And the Higgins fans, and there are plenty of them there, I can tell you, very happy to be sitting there because, excuse me, at one stage yesterday, they thought there mightn't be an afternoon, let alone an evening. But now, the final will definitely go to conclusion of tonight. 7 Higgins, 8 Davis, and I think some fascinating snooker in store for us here this afternoon. It starts in just a few minutes, and we will be there, of course, with the first frame of the session. Well, as I was saying, it was a day of contrast yesterday. Steve Davis came out in the afternoon, starting at 2:15, and literally Higgins had a few chances, didn't take any of them at all, and suddenly, and I think it was suddenly as far as Higgins was concerned, he was 7-0 down. Davis putting a whitewash on him in the afternoon. Then the evening, suddenly it started to change. It transformed Higgins, tapping the cue on the rail, looking much more alive. He took the first frame of the night, he took the second, he took the third, and to be perfectly honest, he should have taken the fourth as well. But he let Davis in, and Davis took it. So it was 3-8. In the 12th frame, he nearly let Davis in again. He started off well, but then Davis, with a break, in fact, of 31, looked to be in command. That's where he broke down, and that's where Higgins came back to the table. 30 Higgins, 35 Davis.
Alex Higgins, 4. Steve Davis, 35. Alex Higgins, 34.
Come to vote for better than that. just have to roll the blue in now to finish nicely on the yellow.
Five points in front then, and just the colours to go.
Eight. 11.
Just looking at the board to see that he needs brown and blue to clinch this frame.
15.
After what he would call a temporary hiccup in frame 11, the Higgins charge was back on. Prowling, prancing, he was almost dancing. What a player he'd become, and what a contrast. In fact, he took the next three as well to give us that score. Alex Higgins, 7. Steve Davis, 8. Remember, this is a best of 31 frame final. 7 to be played this afternoon, 9 tonight, and so you need to win 16 frames to win this title and to win the £12,000. And I think that shows the fascination of snooker. Tea time yesterday, everybody said, well, the robotic Steve Davis, take nothing away from the way he played. He played excellent snooker, doing his job, leading 7-0. It was all going to be over, and suddenly it's all come back. And so now, settle back with us, Sunday afternoon at the final of the championship snooker. What could be better than that? Down in the hall, the crowd are ready. The players waiting to come in. Our announcer just announcing the two contestants here for the 1983 final. Yet another good luck card. The table is littered with them. And there's his biggest fan, the lady from Preston, who sat there throughout the championship.
His opponent, world champion of 1981, the winner of the Coral UK Championship in 1980 and 1981, and the reigning Embassy World Champion from London, Steve Davis.
Well, the Davis fans will match those of Alex Higgins here this afternoon.
Official,
he said before he desperately wants to win this championship a third time. He can't remember the last time he won three titles in the same championship. Can Higgins settle himself down after a tremendous surge of last night? Can he get it all back together? There are the pictures that you'll be seeing in your newspapers tomorrow morning. But this afternoon here, with the best seat in the house, settle back. Watch it all live. Higgins versus Davis for the Coral United Kingdom Trophy of 1983. In the commentary box will be Rex Williams, but first we'll join Clive Everton.
Thank you, gentlemen.
This way, thank you. This way, there we go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. 16th frame. Steve Davis to Brett, leading 8-7. Stroke 4, Alex Higgins.
Not the best way to start the session by Davis. He caught the break-off shot a little too thin. The cue ball ended in the pocket. And the supplementary effect of that is that Higgins can advance the cue ball to the balk line, which makes any red that he might attempt considerably easier than if he was playing from just off the balk cushion. Can Higgins recapture the inspiration of last evening? Well, Steve won't be too happy with that shot. It was a good opening to start, and he didn't play to kiss that red. Played to come across the face of it and leave it into the other pocket.
Steve Davis, 8.
So that was a little bit of a let-off there for Alex. That looks a pretty good safety shot there from Higgins. The balls are nicely open. Steve playing to line to the pack of reds, which is by the pink. He's got to get this one right.
Blue ball. Alex Higgins, 1.
Well, the last thing that Alex wanted was for the blue to go into the pocket. He didn't play to pot it, he played a safety shot. Was a good enough safety shot from Higgins, to force the glimmer of a mistake from Davis. Cue ball covering the black spot, and therefore both pink and black now tied up.
Nine.
Well, Alex took the risk there of trying to split the pink and black because the blue was lying over the pocket, and he thought they would almost certainly have a chance at that.
And now the pink is developed into a potable position.
Higgins
waited at the table to see whether the pink would cover the red that he's just played. Doesn't look from our position that it has.
To the right of the black is the one open red that Steve, I'm sure, would like to get onto.
Four. Seven. Eight.
reasonable choice of pink or black, and the red immediately to the left of the black is the one that I'm sure Steve will be trying to get onto. Well, surprisingly, he was prepared to...
14.
Well, I didn't realize that the pink was going back on the spot. That's why he didn't play for that red. And he tried just to disturb one or two reds to open up. That hasn't dropped too well for him. A little bit unlucky there.
Slightly the wrong side of the blue. If the cue ball had rolled on a couple of inches, it would have been quite easy for him to bring the cue ball towards the reds.
Seven, Steve Davis.
Well, there was a hint of tension in that shot that Davis just played. The cue ball was quite near the side cushion, but not right on it. And normally I expect him to pop those.
Yes, Clive. Steve has got such a beautiful cue action, we don't expect him to miss that type of shot, but it's amazing the way tension affects the coordination.
One. Seven. Eight.
Knew full well if he didn't get the pink, he would have the black into the center.
Twenty-two. 23.
Higgins odds on to clinch this opening frame from this position.
Thirty-six.
And just the red leaves Davis needing a snooker.
Yes, and everybody in the Guildhall realizing the scores.
Too late to make any difference. That has certainly secured the opening frame for Higgins.
Fantastic performance this is. 7-0 down against Steve Davis and levels it at 8 frames all. No matter what the outcome of this match is, eventually that's going to be one of the great performances in the snooker world for a number of years.
Yes, I can possibly compare it with Ray Reardon beating Eddie Charlton from 6 down with 9 to play in the 1975 World Final. But the additional factor here is that Higgins is playing a man who seems well nigh invincible. So 8 frames out of 9 then for Higgins. He levels the match at 8 frames all.
The reception tonight from a packed Guildhall here in Preston for Alex Higgins. The start of the final session of this year's Coral United Kingdom Professional Snooker Championship, and Higgins, who staged the most remarkable comeback in the game of snooker. 7-0 yesterday afternoon, pulling back to one frame yesterday night against this man, Steve Davis, who's twice won the title. This afternoon, they kept in touch. At the end of the afternoon, it was 11 frames all, 9 to play, 16 the target to produce the champion. And what a final we've now got on our hands, which we're going to watch in our two programmes here this evening. Straight to the next frame, 11 all, remember. This is the 23rd frame, Alex Higgins to break. and he looks to be in style. Your commentators, Rex Williams and Clive Everton.
Immaculate start to the final session by Higgins with that break-off shot, and when Davis won the first seven frames yesterday afternoon, few of us thought there would even be an evening session.
Six. Seven.
Hasn't been a kick yet, but Higgins feels that this is a break building opportunity, and he doesn't want anything outside his control to spoil it, so he therefore asked referee Len Ganley to give the cue ball a wipe.
Alex Higgins, 12.
Well, the pot was pretty difficult from so close to the side cushion, and he was also trying to get the cue ball to slide off two or three reds back into position on the black. Pretty complicated positional shot.
Steve played to stun that onto the cushion, didn't intend to catch the black like that.
Seven. 7. Thirteen. 17.18. 25.33. 34. 41. 42.
And who could have thought that Steve Davis, after leading 7-0, could now be watching the probability of falling a frame behind for the first time.
46. 40.
Good start by Higgins, but another red and another colour would have left Davis needing a snooker.
Steve Davis now needs the lot to win, and interesting, Clive, this is probably the first real pressure that Steve has had to put up with in this match.
41.
This is the first time that during the match that Steve could fall behind.
And in fact, he did. A little bit of toing and froing after that. But after 19 minutes of that frame, Alex Higgins was ahead for the first time since his final began. And welcome to our final programme from the Guildhall, Preston, and to the climax of this year's Coral United Kingdom Professional Snooker Championship. With the match still going on, whatever happens between now and the finish is bound to make a significant entry in the record books of the game. The story so far, the tremendous comeback of Alex Higgins. They've now reached 12 frames all, 7 to play, each man needing 4 for the championship. Higgins has got the best start here in frame 25. Davis at the table, there's the score, 1-34. John Spencer is commentating with Jack Carnham.
And Steve quite happy to be taking the small colours to try and develop a position to get in command on the reds.
Now, has a chance here to move the pink when potting this red, knowing he'll still be on the green.
Well,
Steve Davis, 8.
It's not often that he misses shots like that, but Steve trying very hard to keep his concentration.
One.
And now, of course, Alex has a really good chance here. Black and blue, still a bit awkward, but he's got other balls to play with.
Seven.
Again, no. Alex in the situation, we can play for any colour he wants, knowing that he can always fall back on the green if he gets in trouble.
Eight.
So Alex leading by 47 points to 9, and in this frame he's calling the tune at the moment.
14.
I think we're going to see Alex Snooker, Steve, here.
Yes, he was rather unlucky there to a very good pot. He could easily have been sitting on a colour.
18, Alex Higgins. Stroke four, Alex Higgins.
That's another good shot from Alex. Got Steve in quite a bit of trouble here.
Pretty good safety. He's just open the reds a little and put Steve right down in the long grass.
And of course there's no easy path back to the balk end of the table here. It may even force Steve into having a go at this one red, we can see.
He'd like to just nick the edge of the red nearest the blue and get back to balk, but what a dangerous shot. It involves swerve and anything could happen. He nearly found the middle. So just 59 possible points on the table, so Steve hasn't a lot to play with. Well, there is little one can say there. He's really had a swing. Who knows what was going through his mind?
Well, I think what it was, Jack, I think he could pot the red, but it was a natural enough, and he was trying to force it in to avoid the enough, and it hit much too thin. That was a clever shot from Steve. Being 45 points behind, he needs that black out off the cushion, which is what he played, but unfortunately the reds run safe on the other cushion.
And the battle continues. They're really playing the name of the game here, and what a pleasure it is to see snooker at this level. There's so much depending on it, and seeing the real art of the game being displayed in this way. And that was a beauty. Well, I think Alex is going to take this one on. Gave that rather a bit of stick, John.
Yes, of course, there's a lot of pressure out there, Jack. This isn't an easy one for Steve, but he may try to move the other red off the side cushion at the same time as potting this.
Seven.
perfect angle on the black just to fall behind this red. Owen needs the half putts, and this is a real pressure shot. If he takes it on, should he miss it, he's practically certain to leave this red up.
Leading by
quiet, please.
56 to 32 has a real chance if he knocks this in. So Steve Davis now in trouble.
Six. Alex Higgins, six.
It was the blue that settled that frame, and so for only the second time in this two-day final, Alex Higgins was ahead.
First frame and final frame of the evening. Alex Higgins to break. Of the tournament as well.
Couldn't go through this again tomorrow.
A packed house here at the Guildhall, Preston. All eyes intent on every shot. In this, the final frame of the UK Championship 83. Great try.
One.
That caused a few hearts to flutter. And this red's going to open some of the others up. Steve can only wait in that lonely chair for a chance to get at the table. The opening break then to Higgins.
And so important, Ted, to get those few points on the board. But what battlers both these players have shown themselves to be in this match.
Those reds are so nicely spread now. Not one on the cushion.
I think he can just get it this red. Just looking, I think, to play off the green round the angles to try and get Steve in that corner behind the yellow.
but these stars have reached this Coral UK final on two previous occasions. Steve there has won it twice. Alex here has been unlucky. He's lost twice.
Bye.
Points ahead.
And that is really keeping the pressure on. Because looking at the table here, I can't see one ball that Steve can hit that would be safe. The only chance I think he's got is hoping to clip a red and go back down the table.
Hoping to don the UK crown for the first time.
Well, the way he's looking, I think he's trying to come between those two reds to the left of the black spot and across to get this one just to the right of the black. That was the danger. He didn't get through the gap, and now has given Alex an excellent chance.
Seven.
Eight. Well, normally you would think this would be the end of the match, but I'm quite sure every shot is a pressure shot for Alex. Nothing will be easy.
15.
Both players have shown us the artistry of snooker. It's a pity there has to be a loser. Higgins now 48 points in front. Davis yet to score.
Thank you. 29.
This is the one, this blank to leave Steve needing snookers. And this 36. Red, I would think, to clinch the match.
In front. It seems that it's third time unlucky for Steve Davis, but third time lucky for Alex Hurricane Higgins, who dons the Coral UK Championship title for the first time. That's on the way to the pocket. Not sufficient legs. Steve took the advantage in the first session with a whitewash over Alex. 7-0. Alex replied. And so the congratulations and the commiserations. The UK Championship final, one of the best on record, is over. And Alex Higgins is the UK champion 1983.
For Alex Higgins, the UK trophy for the first time, presented by Mr. Ken Tucker, the managing director of Corals. Twice before in the final, now the champion. Steve Davis with a 7-0 lead, which was gradually whittled away. No third trophy for him. Higgins the champion. Tell you what it's like here, watching it all, and what it's like at home. But what's it been like down there, Alex?
Well, I feel like I've been in one of Marilyn Monroe's pictures, Some Like It Hot. But, no, it was very difficult. You know, like, one minute he had the upper hand, the next minute I had the upper hand, and then we both made mistakes. You know, it's an awful lot of pressure. And you can understand why people miss easy shots, right? You know, a lot of pressure. I'm relieved it's all gone.
Well, come across to you, Steve. I mean, I don't need to remind you, I'm sure. After the first session yesterday afternoon, people were talking about, is it worth even coming on Sunday night? You must have felt then that it was all going to go your way.
Yeah, I've been in quite a lot of big leads in the past. One of my first ever ones was against Terry Griffiths, right, in the World Championships, and he pulled that back. I mean, when you're in front by a long way, sometimes it's in a different way, it's just as hard to keep it going. Sometimes you can murder the bloke by a lot, which I've done, and other times you get pulled back because the other guy's got all the chance to sort of show himself because he's a little bit the underdog, and that's what Alex did to a tremendous second section.
But it's a rare thing in a major championship for you to be put under the sort of pressure that you've been put under today, isn't it?
Yes, but it's nice in a way, because if I was to get easy games all the time, I think it would be a bit boring after a while, even for me.
Today's wasn't easy.
Today's definitely wasn't easy. It was a great game, but I mean, I'm glad, as I said beforehand, that Alex is playing better, because it makes some great games, and I like being involved in tight games and hard games just as much, because it's the only way I can get better.
Quite honestly, did the pressure get to you mentally?
There were certain times when I was 7-0 in front, and all of a sudden Alex is pulling back and looking very confident, that perhaps there was a little bit of panic creeps in. The fact that you are that many in front, and all of a sudden you see the lead slipping away. But when it was 12-12, something like that, really, even though we both missed balls, I'd rather be on the table than actually watching. Because I've had the experience of watching in the State Express World Team Championships, right, when you can't do a thing right about it. Right. And at least you're on the table, you've got the chance to either play the shot, and you're your own boss, and that's the great thing about it. And if you miss a shot, well, you've missed it, and you're entitled to miss some every now and again. But overall, it's a great game to be involved with, and you're bound to miss shots through pressure, but you try not to make as many mistakes as the other guy.
Alex, you've done it. Did you seriously think you could do it after yesterday afternoon?
Well, I mean, people tend to rate you off and whatever. I mean, I realise that Steve played well, but I mean, in the past, on numerous occasions, I've been that far behind, and I've come back and won. I must admit, less formidable opponents, but there again, I have really got my head together, and I mean, I have played very determined, you know, disciplined snooker. And I put Steve under the type of pressure that he's put other people under. And eventually, if you keep it up, I mean, there has to be a chink in the armour somewhere. And I found a few chinks in his armour. And I wouldn't say I got nervous near the end, as he probably did as well when he took the lead and so on. But I mean, it is a high-pressure type of game. It's head-to-head. And
how well did you play today in your own mind compared to your other performances?
I think there's, if I keep the same type of discipline, I mean, I'm going to struggle against Steve here, but he's going to struggle against me, because it's very hard for someone like myself, who loves to pot the balls and so on, be a bit flamboyant for the crowd. But I mean, I've found out in the past that it's cost me an awful lot of money. I must admit that my good lady has helped things and spurred me on and made me straighten myself out in many ways.
But I was saying, from the scenes we saw at the end of the match, you've got your game together and your life together.
Yeah, well, this is it. I mean, like, when you've got children and stuff like that, there's an awful lot of things that you can't do and whatever. And the ideal thing is that I now know what I can become, and it's just a matter of discipline all the way around, and well, I think I've sort of proved it today.
Alex Higgins, the champion of the United Kingdom for the first time, Steve Davis, who's won it twice, but not this time, but I'm sure we'll be back. Can I just say what I think everybody who's watched this match will say? Gentlemen, thank you for a tremendous game of snooker.
It was incredible, wasn't it?
Another hand. Right.
Well, we'll echo that. So, a sporting story and a nice domestic story sorted out here at Preston Guildhall. That's it. We'll be back. Oh, no, we won't. We're all going home. So, if you've enjoyed it as much as we have, it's been marvellous. Goodbye now.